welcome. Everybody, this is Yash Lodaya, who is a JGBS MBA graduate from 2014-2016.
Of course, hi. So, I'm Yash Lodaya. I was there in Jindal from 2014 to 2016. It was a very great experience over there, you know, doing my MBA course. And I had just joined in from my after doing my BCom in the HR college, and directly got a scholarship to be a part of Jindal after that. So currently I'm working with Citibank. I'm working as an independent compliance risk management. So basically what my profile entangles is, there are many regulators in India, you know, from RBI, SEBI to NSE, BSE, different kind of regulators where bank has to comply with all the kind of circulars, notifications that we come across. And bank has to be up to date and regularly keep in touch with everything that has been changing, that is coming forward. And that has to be implemented in the bank in various segments, you know, from finance to HR to ICG, to higher level clients. And everyone has to be informed what new is coming up. And that has to be followed in all the government regulators and all kinds of forms, loans and everything, from sanctions to disbursements to. So I have a very broad area to work in, and I have to look after every segment as to whether, you know, they have complied and they're following all the action, and it's been implemented and an action plan has been created where the bank is up to date with all the regulators. So that is the basic job. Other than that, we look after Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and India as a major aspect of our countries. And so we see that everything is followed in these countries, and also with the global, whether we are intact and we have everything in place. So that is the basic job profile. So this profile is very much of a finance background, and you have to be, up to date, and you should have knowledge of various topics of finance, and you should have a clear focus as to what a bank is part of, what products it's offering, what kind of activity it is doing or something that is coming up, and also whatever is the bank that is actually applicable, which may not be applicable to other banks, are taken care of.
What was your experience like getting into Jindal, and especially JGBS? We are talking about JGBS over here. So experience, exposure, whatever you got, like, and I hope you had MBA specialization in finance, like, since you mentioned banking.
Right. So I did my dual MBA in my finance and marketing both. With Jindal. So I think we had to complete a lot of credits, and you know, you can do a dual degree where you can get the exposure of both finance and marketing as well. And I think banking as a whole is a mix of both finance and marketing at the end, where you have to somewhere look at the financial aspect and marketing as well. So from the beginning, I'll say that I was doing my BCom from HR college, where you know, the various all the deans of the various schools and also the vice chancellor came to a college, and they gave a presentation. They explained to students, you know, what are the benefits of coming to the college, and they also offered us a scholarship to join the college. Yeah, so I got a scholarship, a good scholarship, and I was really inclined joining Jindal, and so that's how I came across Jindal. And I think doing an MBA after BCom really helped me in making my whole personality development was in over there.
Yes, talking about like opportunities at campuses, and especially since you did a dual degree MBA, there must have been a lot of electives to study upon, and a lot of to, like, academically a lot to explore. So if you could know anything about that.
Right, from the beginning when we were given the options of selecting different credits and what subjects you wanted to do or what electives you wanted to select. So from the beginning, we were offered to take up a language course, which was French or, you know, Chinese or such courses where you can do. And also there were other law related courses from environmental tax or law, corporate governance. So I took up corporate governance in the first semester itself. And I think that also helps you get more extra credits through that. And also it's a different learning experience where I think from there itself, I developed an interest in doing LLB as well, which I took up at a later stage. So doing such courses really helps you to develop what things you know, things you don't know. Like in corporate governance, it deals with the various frauds that came up with RIL or the Hutchinson-Mehta case and all such things. So I think you get to know a lot of stuff when you take up extra courses, and it helps you to gain a good knowledge of things which actually you don't even need it, but it's a good advantage for you to have.
Okay, especially since JGU, like you're referring to JGU being a multidisciplinary campus, and you know that advantage that you will be getting as a business student, I guess.
The multidisciplinary campus really helps us, and there are various schools of journalism and political aspects where you can look into it and get those courses also done along with your MBA. So it could help you in the future and to which direction you're looking at. And at the broader aspects, you really have something in your mind and you can do that course. And you will get to know whether you want to pursue that course future in the future or not. So that really helps you go ahead.
Yeah, I hope. I think it just expands your limits and just, you know, let you explore a lot on other sectors as well. So apart from the extracurricular, apart from the sports, apart from whatever you're interested, especially I can see JGBS won't let you down on any interest and stuff like that the students might have with all these clubs. And there are a lot of clubs and societies. Were you a part of any such?
I was a part of the finance club since the beginning for the 2 years. And in the second year, I was the finance club president. So I mean, there were many more clubs like operational clubs and cultural clubs and marketing clubs. So all such clubs are given a whole student volunteers who would like to be a part of it and organize any kind of event that they like from the beginning. Like, so I think keeping such clubs makes you more involved and more abreast with the related topics that are going on. And like I was the finance club president, so we used to organize various events where, you know, there are certain quizzes where your general knowledge is tested. Then we had for, I think my club had around 30 people. So we used to organize within our club, we used to organize a kind of a lecture or something where students who had certain specific knowledge about certain topics of finance would come ahead, give a presentation, and you know, just talk with the people as to what knowledge they have and they can share with other people. So that was a good part that we had organized. And also there was a business fest organized, which was Sumplug, which we did in the first year, in the second year itself. It was the first Sumplug organized for the business fest. So that for which we had organized a stock trading event, which was a 1 week event. Okay, so where we had collaborated with an online virtual stock trading company, which was Track Invest. So So it was not only limited to our college, but also the other colleges that were coming in for a business fest were also given an opportunity to join in this event. And they had to, they were given some points and they had to invest those points into different stocks for a week, and whoever gets the more profit would win the part. And then after that, there would be a presentation round where how they had invested and what kind of thinking they had to invest in that stock would be discussed. Yeah, the analysis would be done. And other people would get to know how to how the stock market works and how people look at it, the trend, the analysis that they do, so that they could, you know, earn such a profit that they can in a normal life. This was just a virtual way where you have to just invest points. But, you know, this could help in the future for people to invest in. That was a great experience with it. Yeah. So actually, even the first prize that was won was from a different college.
Oh, that's actually something that I haven't heard before, you know. That's great initiatives by, you know, Finance Club and all the other, I mean, I bet all the other clubs and societies had initiatives like that related to their field of interest. And you know. Right. So
every club had their own events, and even together they could club a event and, you know, organize it together. Or there used to be factory visits as well, where, you know, mm-hmm. we get visited a rice factory, a Paliji factory. So such kind of visit really helps us to know how manufacturing works or how different industries are going on today. So there were two main events that were organized, which are Conclave and the Samta. Mm-hmm. So after that, there used to be, you know, every 2 weeks or something, some person which is at a higher position in some company, we used to invite them, used to get them on the campus, mm-hmm. and let them speak to the students and, you know, share their experience, what their interests are, and, you know, the students can really interact with these people and get to know more about how they have developed themselves and how they have been hired in the industry. So that has really helped us, and not only the other faculties that used to come in, but also the other such people that were coming in, but our professors also have used to go to, you know, different educational conclaves, different seminars, like Professor Brijesh Agarwal is there, Brijesh Kumar is there.
He's still
who had a presentation on his own. He's still there, right?
Yeah.
So he had a presentation on his own paper that he had written,
mm-hmm.
for which around 5 to 10 people of us had gone, and we had that experience to be a part of his presentation over there. So that is a great experience that the JGBS is letting people, you know, travel such distance and, you know, be a part, if it's in Delhi or anywhere, and mm-hmm. be a part of such activity.
That's actually great to hear, you know, that professors actually take interest in letting the, just apart from the academic stuff. Earlier you told about the sports and enthusiastic professors, now about Brijesh Kumar, so he's still there. I haven't met him in person, but yeah, I've been in a couple of meetings with him. So like, talking about professors, like who else was there, or even Brijesh Kumar, so like how they influenced you, even in academics, how they actually helped you improve your managerial
So for finance, I was really interested into finance, so I was more in touch with Professor Ravi Agarwal and Professor Brijesh Kumar.
Mm-hmm.
Which really helped me to know more in detail about what is finance related to, what kind of interest areas. If there was some books that we wanted, they provided us with those books to refer. Also, we could do projects or reports with them, you know, where you could take up a specific topic and mm-hmm. present a paper to them. And, you know, such kind of research, such activities really helps to develop what you know about a particular field. And not only related to finance, also in the last semester I took up a project with Professor Renu Emily,
mm-hmm.
Where I could get some extra credits from her, and I could also be, you know, researching on a marketing topic and make a report, and that would really help even the professors in their papers or something that they write. So it's a great to be a part of something that other professors are doing, and we could, you know, put some part of us anyway.
Yeah, that's actually great to hear as well. So that professors include students, bright students like you, like in their projects, in the work that they do, the paper that they publish. And I have, like, I too had a similar experience. Like, you know, I have this professor, Richa Shukla. She teaches us philosophy in this semester, and she has actually offered that she had given us a research paper to work on, and if the research paper is good enough, that's something that she feels like she can put in some effort and make it to a standard research paper, then she'll actually help us publish in one of the leading a few leading online platforms. And that's like a great opportunity for a first year student, like a student who has not even expecting anything from the first 3-4 years, right? We all expect everything to get towards the final years, and that's like from day one, that kind of culture and that kind of vibe is what I've also been getting. So I totally relate to that. Basically, like talking to you, like I have gotten a really lot of you know, like I'm just hyped up to be in the campus, right? To just make use of all the opportunities that has been that will be thrown at me. And yeah, there are definitely challenges and hurdles to take pass. And I know that the faculty, the students, especially the peers, and also that business school will radiate that management, like energy, right, towards the end. So definitely, like towards the end of this entire interview, is there something that you would actually love to say to the upcoming students, like to the to your juniors, especially as a person who has graduated from there like around 5 years ago? So
to the juniors, I'd like to say that enjoy the campus, the whole life. You know, right now you're work, you know, doing the call, studying from home, but once you're in the campus, you'll enjoy it even more. And you should really focus on your academics, get to do different courses, put in a little effort, and you can do many more courses, get more credits, and which will really help you in the future. As right now, like I'm doing the finance part, which is a limited part, but if you do the extra courses of finance which are there, which are provided by JGU itself, you will be even better at working in the future life. So I like to say that do your credits well, enjoy your sports life over there and the campus, and just get your MBA and you'll be a good with the placements as well.
Yeah, and that's actually really good to hear. That's actually really motivating for us. And once again, thank you Mr. Yash Lodaya for joining us and giving this wonderful session for us, spending time with us, and thank you once again.